So today let's make another episode of my Solid State Tesla Coil series. In this episode I'm going to compare IGBT transistors with MOSFETs. I'm going to talk about what they have in common, what are the differences and the advantages and disadvantages of each. And I'm going to choose which ones to use for my Solid State Tesla Coil. But of course this can apply to basically the choice of switching component for any switching application. And of course there are also bipolar transistors, but they are not very suitable for a solid state Tesla coil because they are usually too slow. A solid state Tesla coil is switching at about tens to hundreds of kilohertz. And also bipolar transistors need quite a lot of current into their base. So for a solid state Tesla coil, the choice is basically just MOSFETs or IGBT transistors. MOSFETs and IGBT transistors are actually quite similar. They both have a gate instead of a base. They are not like a bipolar transistor, which requires a low voltage, high current to keep it on. The base of a bipolar transistor is basically acting as a diode, and in big ones, you have to constantly supply a high current through it to keep it on. But in a MOSFET or IGBT, the gate is basically acting as a capacitor. It's like having a capacitor here, and to turn it on, you have to charge the capacitor, and to turn it off, you have to discharge the capacitor. But in a steady state, the gate doesn't draw any current. So those are kind of interchangeable, but there are some differences. MOSFETs generally come in a wider voltage range. They go from as low as 20 volts to about 1200 volts. IGBT transistors are generally meant just for higher voltages. They go from about 300 volts to 1200 volts, and of course some big expensive ones can go even higher. And MOSFETs are made for currents from very low currents like milliamps to high currents like tens of amps or maybe hundreds of amps recently. IGBT transistors are generally for higher currents, tens of amps or more. And a MOSFET, when it's on, is acting as kind of a resistor from here to here. So basically, the voltage drop on it grows linearly with the current through it. And of course, the conductive losses on it depend on this resistance, the on-state resistance of the MOSFET. So when choosing a MOSFET, you want this resistance to be as low as possible. And for low voltages, MOSFETs are better than IGBT transistors because low voltage ones have the resistance super low. So at low voltages, they can be much more efficient than IGBT transistors. Low voltage ones can have the resistance as low as just like 1 or 2 milliohms. So they are super efficient for low voltages. But higher voltage MOSFETs have higher resistance. Of course, the more powerful MOSFET, the lower the resistance, but generally, higher voltage ones have much higher resistance. And it's acting as a resistor, so the voltage drop on it goes up almost linearly with the current, like this. On the other hand, an IGBT transistor, when it's on, it's acting more like a diode in forward. It tends to have a voltage drop, which doesn't change much with the current. So its voltage drop is something like this. It doesn't grow much with the current. So for lower currents, the MOSFETs may be more efficient because if the resistance is low enough and the current is not too high, the voltage drop of it can be very low. But at a higher current, the voltage drop just goes up too much. So for very high currents or very high pulsed currents, IGBT transistors may be better because the voltage drop doesn't grow much with the current. The voltage drop is more or less almost steady and it usually tends to be about 1.5 to 3 volts. In low voltage circuitries, those voltage drops are quite significant, so IGBT transistors are used just for higher voltages. They have the most advantages for high current, high voltage applications. Another difference is that MOSFETs are a bit faster than IGBT transistors. MOSFETs are generally used up to about 500 kHz, but IGBT transistors just up to about 100 or 200 kHz. But of course, over time, you get faster and faster types. They are improving. Another difference is that a MOSFET always has a built-in diode, anti-parallel diode. And it cannot be separated from the transistor because it's basically the transistor die itself. The MOSFET die itself is acting as a diode in antiparallel. A MOSFET is basically a diode with a gate that can turn a diode into a short circuit. On the other hand, an IGBT transistor doesn't have always to have a built-in reverse diode. The transistor die itself is not acting as a diode in antiparallel, and the transistor may actually have built-in diode in it, but this diode is a separate die. It's not a part of the transistor. Of course, it may be an advantage to have a built-in diode in a MOSFET, but this built-in diode is usually not very fast, and this can be a problem at high frequencies. If you use an IGBT transistor, you may connect an ultra-fast diode externally, or you can choose some which has a built-in diode which is fast enough. And there is one more difference. The gate of both is acting more or less the same. It's a capacitor that you charge to turn it on or discharge to turn it off, but the difference is in the threshold voltage and the voltage to safely turn it on. A MOSFET starts to turn on at about 2 to 4 volts and it's fully on at about 5 to 8 volts. An IGBT transistor requires about double the voltage on its gate. It starts to turn on at about 5 to 8 volts, but to turn it reliably on, you need about 10 or more volts, or even 15 volts. A gate driving circuitry of an IGBT transistor has to have at least about 12 or even 15 or 18 volts to control it reliably. The gate of an IGBT transistor is less sensitive, it requires about double the voltage. But on the other hand, the capacitance of the gate tends to be lower for IGBT transistors, so it's a bit easier to charge or discharge. And now of course I have to decide which ones to use for my solid state Tesla coil. It's going to be running from rectified mains for simplicity and enough power. Because the small ones, especially the single transistor ones, usually run from some lower voltage, from some power supply, but the bigger ones, half bridge or bridge ones, usually use a rectified mains voltage. This makes them simple and they don't need any big heavy transformer. This is my mains and after rectification it gives 325 volts. MOSFETs come in quite a variety of voltage ratings, but 400 volt ones are still not recommended because there is not that much headroom. So a MOSFET should be from about 500 volts to about 650 volts for this. Of course the ones for a higher voltage would have even more headroom, but the problem is that they also have higher resistance, they are more expensive and they tend to be slower. So if you use MOSFETs, you aim for those voltages. And IGBT transistors don't have such a big choice of voltages, but they are usually 300 volts, something like 450 volts maybe, and then 600 or 650 volts. So to have enough headroom and to use some more common types, you probably look for those voltage ratings, if you have this mains voltage. And I was looking for something rated about 60 amps at 100 degrees Celsius. And of course the current rating differs for different temperatures. At room temperature the current rating is higher, but it never stays at room temperature. So you look at the high temperature current rating, of course. So I was comparing MOSFETs and IGBT transistors for those voltages and this current rating. And it turned out that MOSFETs for this rating are about 3 or 4 or even 5 times more expensive than IGBT transistors with the same rating. Until recently, MOSFETs were not rated for high voltages and high currents at the same time. Now they are available, but they are still quite expensive, so I decided for IGBT transistors. And they also have a lower gate capacitance, they can handle high currents. And the recent ones are not that slow, they are getting faster and faster. And they are still a little slower than MOSFETs, but my secondary is probably going to be about 110 or 120 kHz. And this shouldn't be a problem for modern IGBTs. The only disadvantage is that the gate requires more voltage. But I plan to use about 15 volts, so it shouldn't be a problem. So this is Diagon Wild and see you in my next videos, and thanks to all of my patrons on Patreon. I really appreciate your support. And in the next episode, I plan to take a look at available types of IGBT transistors and choose some with enough current rating, voltage rating, power dissipation rating, and, of course, fast enough. And of course, also not too expensive.